Year 5, The Rule of Royal W. With the successful test of the fort's emergency containment system, we're finding ourselves short a leader. Seems as though the only surviving previous overseer is quite content to wander about, nose buried in a book, or indulge in his newest hobby, aerobic exercise. Frog is operating a screw pump into the magma reservoir. He's staying in shape and helping the greater good towards its ultimate security. Either way, he's too busy to be managing the day-to-day operations of our glorious Headshoots. So it falls to me to guide our people to glory and security now and in the future. Seems as though my first challenge has already presented itself. Small goblin raiding party has come to test itself against the might of the dwarves. Fortunately, a lookout was able to spot them coming in time for us to raise the drawbridge, allowing our champions to rest up and be fully refreshed going into battle. As I expected, our fine military handled the threat quite efficiently. They even took time out for a little sport.
What a glorious day for Dwarf Ball, folks! Both the Armored Odors and the Knuts of Glasping have been deadlocked at 1-1, all the way past the ninth inning and into overtime, with incredible defense on both sides! But what's this? Momu's Magic Johnzor steals the goblin and passes it to Yuris McGretzky, all the way into the end zone! He lines up the shot and... goal! The Knuts win the Ashes!
25th of Granite, 110. It seems as though Apotheosis has been inspired to creativity. He keeps screaming about needing gems, although we have both rough and cut gems. Apparently the gems we have are not good enough for him. I'll keep an eye on him. Apotheosis has found his gems. Let's see what he makes. Arak Bebmal, the Shaft of Glens. This is a maple amulet. All crafts dwarfship is of the highest quality. It is encircled with bands of maple. This object is adorned with hanging rings of praise and menaces with spikes of sunstone. Our military has grown accustomed to being inside, so I'm sending them out on patrol to keep them prepared. Blast, the goblins snuck up on us. Let's hope Perfect Potato has some good running legs. Perfect Potato Dumatfeb has been stunned. Their left upper leg is severely injured. Their right lower leg has been cut off. Well, he had good legs. Rest well, brother dwarf. For a fort this size, we have a depressingly small number of miners. I've commissioned a run of picks to be made in order to facilitate our continued expansion. When will the dwarfs learn to keep their pet population under control? The amount of mangy dogs allowed to roam the fort at will is alarming, to say the least. Then I find out we don't even employ a butcher? When did the elves come in and keep us from our meat? This has since been remedied. Looks like we've had some more brave souls venture out to our fort. I think they'll be used to bolster our military. While I have absolute faith in the strength of the righteous barricades, I'd rather be on the safe side. 27th of Hematite, 110. One of our newcomers, Punkaune, has found his muse and is currently headed to claim a leatherworks. Some humans have arrived and seem interested in bartering with us. Let's see how much we can take from them for our superior works. The enemy has besieged our home. The time to act is now. Nemo 2342 Sazir Kudust Kogutid, elite wrestler, cancels Phil Waterskin. Interrupted by Goblin Hammerman. All Nemo 2342 wanted was some water. Don't come between a dwarf and his water. The Goblin Hammerman has been hit with a sword so hard that he has exploded into tiny chunks. Apparently our weapon designs were unnecessary. We have a roving pack of doomsday devices at our disposal. All of the goblins in the squad have been absolutely destroyed by Nemo 2342. One goblin is flung away 50 tiles and hits a wall. The force of impact was so strong, that goblin was decapitated and dismembered when he hit the wall. The little chunk to the right of his corpse is his head. The titan, Etha Edenunaquina Emayane, has come. We have a visitor. I'll update as soon as this ends. Holistic detective and wandering knitter approach the titan and destroy it utterly.
Do not fuck with Headshoots. We bring the gods themselves to their knees.
14th of Limestone, 110. Autumn is now upon us, and we're preparing for the winter ahead. I've taken some time to remodel areas of our fort. While this room may have worked when our fort was a simple stopping point, I feel that it's time to upgrade in order for more of our dwarves to sit comfortably. Also seen, expanded food storage. I've also expanded and engraved the workers' and nobles' living quarters. We have a room for another decently sized wave of immigrants.
Nemo2342 posted,
"Am I a champion yet?"
Also, that's pretty awesome that we took down a titan. Maybe we should go after the demons guarding our sweet, sweet adamantium next.
No, not yet. You're still elite.
Grunty Thirst posted, "Hey, where's the artifact description page? Don't hold back on us."
Here are the artifacts that I think I haven't posted yet.
Udo Suvar, Manlulled, a red sandbag. This is a red sandbag made of jaguar leather. All crafts dwarfship is of the highest quality. It is encircled with bands of jaguar leather. Enchaloslan, Bud Wound. This is a highwood earring. All crafts dwarfship is of the highest quality. It is studded with steel and encircled with bands of tower cap and dog bone. This object menaces with spikes of highwood and tower cap. On the item is an image of an adamantine plate cuirass in horse leather. On the item is an image of a dwarf and dwarves in one-humped camel leather. The dwarf is surrounded by the dwarves.
So, here's a quick update.
Pimp Must Athelshigos, Stonecrafter, has given birth to a girl.
Congratulations to Dwarf Must and Baby.
Rathen Thimshurbomrek, the Extractor, has given birth to a boy.
Also to Rathen.
Oh, fuck, I melted the wrong cage. A giant desert scorpion has once again escaped into the fortress. It has been killed.
Welp. The latest wave has brought us to 100 dwarfs. Congratulations, Headshoots. Finally, we get some action. I was expecting to wind down the winter in peace and quiet. Things don't look so good.
Slan Alilikot, Crafts Dwarf, has been struck down by a goblin wrestler.
The barricades just couldn't make it in time. But they are on their way. Or they're asleep. This is the only screen cap I have of that fight, but it was a pretty standard barricades fare. I think 3 goblins got sent into orbit this time. Fun fact, this is 3 Z levels down below the rest of the fight.
A goblin is being flung through the air. Twinge Crag Tadtun. Twinge Crag Matched Doors, Peasant. Twinge Crag has been miserable lately. She was upset about being expelled from the fortress guard. She received food recently. She has been exhausted lately. She has complained of hunger lately. She has received water recently. She has complained of thirst lately. She sustained major injuries recently.
Looks like she's had enough of lying in bed, not sleeping, and she's lost her mind. My year is now over.